We'd like to welcome to Syracuse University new director of athletics, Mark Coyle. And Mark, great to see you, hear your message today. Welcome to Orange Nation.
Thank you. You know, we're very excited to be here. As I mentioned in the press conference, you know, my wife and our three children can't wait to get out here and get started. It's such a special place, and we really look forward to getting here and making Syracuse a home for us.
I know coming from Boise State, you'll be able to, as a family, keep a lot of your orange and blue. What was the reaction from your family? It's a big decision to move across the country here. How did you pitch it to them? What were the discussions, and how was the reaction?
Yeah, you know, the kids were excited. You know, I literally took a picture of when Syracuse played Duke last year in the Carrier Dome, and our boys saw that crowd, and they were on board right away. And our daughter Gracie, we had talked to her quite a bit about, hey, there's going to be one more move. And once she saw that we were coming out here, she was excited because the colors do match Boise State. So that part was a good transition for her in the wardrobe.
Very good. When you get to a basketball game with 30,000 plus, it's an experience unlike anywhere else, and I'm sure you'll enjoy that. As you evaluated this and you were the finalist for other athletic director jobs, how did you line yourself, your background up with Syracuse and the needs here? How did you presume yourself a fit?
Well, you know, it's very similar to Boise State. You know, when I went to Boise State, they had just gone through some NCAA infractions. And when I saw Syracuse and I saw the situation, I felt like I'd be a good fit because I just went through that process. And I felt like, you know, I could come in here and take what I learned at Boise State and apply it to Syracuse. And again, we've had a lot of success at Boise State because I've got a phenomenal staff back there. And I know there's great people here. And again, we're excited to come here and work with them and get this thing going where we want to go.
And doing some homework on your background and the places you've been, certainly Kentucky as a number two, going on to Boise State as the athletic director the past 3.5 years. People say, number one, integrity. Number two, transparency. Clearly, those are things that are important, regardless of whether you're dealing with an NCAA circumstance. Yeah. But I would imagine that's kind of how you attack that.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, I'm a big believer. You know, you got to live in truth always, mm-hmm. and you got to be very transparent. You know, and I talk about all the time. You know, we all make mistakes every day. I make mistakes every day. You make mistakes, mm-hmm. and it's how you deal with those mistakes. And I think if you're honest and transparent, you can work your way through a lot of those things. And again, my goal is to make sure that we run an athletic department that's first class, an athletic department that represents this great institution in a positive manner at all times.
Connection to the community, another thing that's kind of been indicated by the search community as important, and they identified you as somebody capable of doing that. Fundraising background is maybe a little bit distinct. How do you go about establishing that?
Well, you know, I think you have to create access points for people. Mm-hmm. You know, I think you'll see that I'll be very visible in the community. You know, I like to get out and meet people and spend time with people. And I think, again, you know, you create access points where people feel a part of your program. You know, the Orange Nation is strong, you know, and we've got wonderful fans here, you know, not only in Syracuse and Central State, but the entire state. And my job is to make sure we bring all those people together and make sure we're all rolling in the same direction and accomplishing the goals we want to have for Syracuse.
A quick run through of your background. A master's degree from Florida State.
Yep.
After playing football at Drake. So you've got a little bit of connection to that part of the world and to this conference, as it turns out. Cut your teeth really at Kentucky with the highly respected Mitch Barnhart, working your way up. There's also a stop at Host Communications in there, which helps you negotiate a deal, I'm sure, with Learfield.
Yep.
At Boise. Do you feel as though that's kind of prepped you for all of the different things for a big-time job in a major conference school, given that you've played the field of different positions?
Yeah, you know, I think I've had a unique background. You know, mm-hmm. as you touched on, having a chance to work for Host Communications, now IMG, for 6 years. You know, and when I left Host Communications, I was a vice president of the Collegiate Sports Division, so I was, mm-hmm. you know, doing the multimedia rights deals and got a good feel for that. And then being at Kentucky for 7 years, you know, and being around that basketball program and the football program, the other 18 sports, and competing at such a high level in the SEC, and then going out to Boise State and having a chance, you know, for the first time to run my own department. You know, and I was able to take what I learned from my previous stops and apply it. And again, we had great success at Boise State because we had great people, and there's no doubt we have great success here because of the great people in place here.
You've come, there's a lot of different angles. You've come through the external affairs world. Yep. It could have been facilities. It could have been through coaching, et cetera. That's the path that you've gotten to this point. What is it that you're most proud of, whether it's at Boise, Kentucky, or a previous stop that's marked your career?
You know, I'm very proud of our academic achievements. You know, Boise State, you know, we won 5 conference championships this year. And you know, this year we placed the most kids on the all-scholar team in the Mountain West Conference. We set our highest grade point average in school history. You know, 18 of 19 teams set their highest GPA marks. So I'm a big believer that you can have success academically and athletically, mm-hmm. and I'm very proud of those accomplishments.
Boise has been known from this corner of the world for being removed by a couple of time zones as an incredible football background. Now, if you go way back, junior college and fighting their way through, and then busting through kind of the lower levels to kick down the door of the BCS.
Yeah.
I know they're very proud of that, and you were able to maintain that. Keeping Chris Peterson, you know, people talk about, oh, you're pretty sure Brian Harsin, which obviously it was a very clear choice to for that job. But keeping Chris Peterson for as long as you did had to take some skill, as did steering Boise into a conference, you know, that kept you out west. How did you work through those types of things, and what have you learned through that that helps when you come here?
Well, I learned patience through that. You know, when I first got to Boise State, they were in the Big East Conference. You know, they just made the announcement they're going to be in the Big East Conference. And so I literally went to three different sets of conference meetings. I went to the Big East meetings, I went to the Big West meetings, and I went to the Mount West meetings. You know, so I got exposed to a lot of different parts from that standpoint. And again, we were kind of patient and we weighed all of our options. And the Mount West was the best fit for us. You know, and once we went through that process and working closely with our president, Dr. Kustra, who gave so much support to our program, you know, that was a huge benefit to being at Boise State. And then in terms of Coach Peterson, you know, he and I developed a really good relationship quickly. You know, he and I are very similar in our demeanor and in our thought process and our value system. And so he and I, you know, each year schools would call him, and, you know, and we were able to keep Chris with new contracts from that standpoint. And then once Chris did make the transition, as you noted, Brian Harsin was such a great fit for our program that we felt was like the right thing to do to move us forward.
12 football wins a year ago. Now, as you're doing your homework on Syracuse, how do you go about evaluating it? What did you determine are strengths, and what are areas of improvement needed?
Well, you know, as I talked about at the press conference, you know, I think Syracuse has such a strong, strong national and international brand. I mean, you show that block S, people know what that is. You know, they know what it represents from that standpoint. And I think sometimes when you're in it day in and day out, you lose sight of that. You know, and I think part of my job is to come in here and listen and come in here and gather information. But again, I think a strength of Syracuse is the ACC. You know, it's one of the high resource five conferences. And how can we put ourselves in a position to compete for ACC championships? Because if you're competing for championships in the ACC, you're going to be competing on the national level, the high level. And that's my goal for all of our sports, is to compete at a high level and make an impact on that scene.
And so many of the sports fielded here, the ACC is, if not the very best conference, it's right there.
Yep.
So is that something you've gotten as you're starting to build relationships with, in particular, the Olympic sport coaches? Forget about Coach Boeheim and Coach Schaefer for a moment, because I'm sure they're all eager to hear what your approach is.
Yeah, you know, and I had a chance to reach out to all of them yesterday. You know, I was able to reach out and talk with a lot of those coaches. And again, I think they really appreciate the fact that I do want a broad-based program. You know, and I recognize success. I think in the Director's Cup, you know, Syracuse is always in the top 30, top 40 from that standpoint, and my goal is to continue to have us move up from those Director Cup standings. And again, the Olympic sports, you know, I use the analogy when a young lady in softball sprains her ankle, you know, it hurts just as bad as when the starting quarterback sprains his ankle. You know, they go through the same rehab, and I want to make sure that we focus on all of our student athletes and give them a chance again to win at the highest level.
Okay, you'll be on the job July 6th. I know you'll kind of work your way in. It sounds like listening is an important thing for you to begin with. What types of things are sort of foremost on your game plan for when you're here with your family for real?
Well, you know, the first thing is obviously to get my family settled. You know, once I get my family, you know, my wife is phenomenal, and she's been a trooper throughout this whole process, and our kids have been great. But, you know, in terms of the staff, I just want to make sure the staff has a chance to get to know me. You know, I think they'll see that I'm a pretty easygoing, even-keeled person, and I'm an open person where I want to get to know people and know what gets them excited and what energizes them. Because I think if we have our staff excited and we're all focused on our student-athletes, things will fall into place, and we'll work our way through this, and it's going to be a positive experience for all involved.
Okay, makes sense. Looking forward to it. People are excited to see you out and about. You've got that S roll in there, and a busy week. Welcome aboard.
Thank you so much for everything.
That's Mark Coyle. Much more at Cuse.com.